This is a dumb turtle, and this is a ninja. What if I told you that you can harness the power of Python and genetic algorithms to transform this humble dumb turtle into a skilled ninja? I'll guide you through this process with visual explanations and provide you with a Python code utilizing one of the best genetic algorithm libraries. Let's visualize this maze. The manhole here represents the starting point, and the objective is to reach the pizza as quickly as possible. However, there is one constraint here, that these orange cells are walls and can't be crossed. Our goal is to transform this dumb turtle, which currently moves randomly, into a laser-focused ninja with a clear sense of purpose. A genetic algorithm is a problem-solving technique that is inspired by nature to find optimal solutions. By iteratively evolving a population of potential solutions through selection, mating, and mutation. We will begin our journey into genetic algorithms by introducing a population of random individual turtles. Please note that there is nothing particularly special about these turtles. They are all essentially dumb turtles. Anyway, each one of these turtles possesses a random signature move, which is represented by their genome. And it's instruction-like, right, up, right, down, and left. It's important to understand that these genomes represent the solution to our problem. In this particular example, you can observe that the turtle crossed the wall, which is not allowed. In the next step, I'll demonstrate how we handle such constraints. Similarly, the turtle retraced its steps, which is not necessarily a constraint, but it's not an effective behavior. And we want to discourage. We will address that in the upcoming step as well. Another thing to notice is that not all turtles have the same length of genes. And this is by design, because we don't know how many steps we need to reach the desired pizza. For example, this one has a 5-step genome, while the one I showed earlier has a 6-step genome. The primary factor that we aim to minimize is the distance between the turtle's final position and the pizza. And we will use Manhattan distance metric here since our maze is grid-based. Manhattan distance is calculated by summing the difference in the x and the y coordinates. So this one, delta x is 11, delta y is 12, we end up with 23. It's essential to note that we want to prevent the turtle from crossing walls. Therefore, we will apply penalty each time a turtle crosses a wall. However, instead of counting the number of times it crosses a wall, I prefer to calculate it as a percentage of the genome's length. Otherwise, we will penalize longer genomes more as they tend to cross more walls compared to shorter ones. So one crossing out of 6 steps, this is 0.167 or 16.7%. Similarly, is one retrace out of 6 steps, and we end up with 16.7%. As a punishment, I will incorporate these penalties into the distance calculation, resulting in larger numbers indicating lower fitness. Remember, our goal is to minimize the distance, and crossing the wall carries a higher penalty. Note that I multiply the penalty for crossing the wall by 200, while the penalty for retracing is only multiplied by 50. This signifies that crossing the wall is more strongly discouraged than retracing. Keep in mind that these values of 250 are arbitrary and could have been 300 or 100, for example. So we get a total fitness here of 64.7. As another example, this one is 19 blocks away from the pizza and it doesn't cross any walls or retrace itself, so we end up with a fitness score of 19. So we apply this logic to every individual to evaluate his fitness. Next, we need to choose individuals from the current population to serve as parents for the next generation. One of the most common methods is tournament selection, where the population is randomly divided into subgroups and a small tournament is conducted. The individuals compete, and the most fit individual is selected for the next step. Note that the size of the subgroup is a parameter that we need to experiment with. So we have this turtle here as a winner because it has the lowest distance among them, and that is its genome. And here is another turtle from the second group. The next step is to combine pair of parent individual to create new offspring. This is often done by swapping or mixing the genetic information or the genes of the parent. This process is called crossover, and it helps explore the solution space by blending traits of successful solutions. One of the methods is to randomly divide the genome in two locations and swap parts between parents before reassembling the genes. Here, we have generated two offspring, but we can produce as many as desired. This is also one of the parameters that we need to experiment with and adjust. The last step involves introducing small random changes or mutations to the offspring genes. Mutations add diversity to the population and to prevent the algorithm from getting stuck in local minima. For example, these two genes can be swapped to form a mutation. And it's important to note that such mutations could either lead to a favorable or unfavorable result. Here is a very favorable result, while this one is less favorable result. This result here is unfavorable, most likely due to mutation. Then, we continue generating generations from each offspring until we either reach a plateau in the solution's improvement, or we reach a maximum number of generations that we have specified beforehand. Alright, while showing you the results I got from the Python script linked in the description below, it's important to know that genetic algorithms are a powerful optimization tool but require careful parameter selection and objective intelligent design to avoid wiping out solution populations. Harsh penalties for undesired traits, for example, can disrupt the process, and the population size is crucial for efficiency. Contrary to misconceptions, genetic algorithms are the result of thoughtful design, not blind randomness. Final note here that nature's complexity far exceeds the controlled parameters of a genetic algorithm, making it clear that these algorithms, while inspired by nature, are a simplified and controlled approach to optimization problems. If you like this content, please like, share, and subscribe.